All right, hello everyone. My name is Vodgern and welcome back to Psychonauts. Last time we left off, Lily got taken by a monster. So now we gotta go save her. Okay. See it. Come on, pull it out of the ground. There we go. Ooh, a hundo, not too bad. Yep.
Admiral, sir, did you hear that? The hideous hulking lungfish of Lake Oblongata just kidnapped Lily.
Lungfish? So that's what's been tearing up my canoes. Well, I know just what to do.
You do? Great!
Yeah, I've got some lungfish proof shellac. I'll just slap on a fresh coat, maybe two, and that's that.
Admiral, the monster is still out there, and Coach Oleander is trying to take over the world.
Ah, yes, the world's a crazy place, son, but don't worry. The canoes are safe.
Oh, thank God, the canoes will be safe. Can you imagine what would happen if we lost the canoes? Anything but the canoes. The dollar market can, you know, the dollar can literally go down to a value of nothing. But if we lose the canoes, God help us all. Dumb. And I love how, Crawler's like thing for the best of fear is like, you've never been to summer camp? Also, lungfish are really weird. Like, have you ever seen them up on YouTube? I'll post like a picture or something of a lungfish.
Still glowing. This must be where he brought Lily. Ha!
Now, where are you?
And no one gets hurt, fish. Man, it's gonna be hard to find a new place to give you lumps.
But yeah, lungfish are really, really weird. It's like three, and then he starts like changing up his tactics. Yep. Now this is a cool mechanic right here, where the monster's chasing us. And you see the green hands out there? Those are letting me know that I'm getting too close to the edge of the air bubble. But yeah, I mean, this whole thing was like, and the monster's head is even better. Because I don't know many games that do boss fights like this. Like where you're inside the vision of whatever's chasing you. And I like how you see like the fish and the plant life all starting to fall down on their own. I forgot the name of those, the curse. That's the reason why Raz can't go into water. There's a specific name for it. It's like the curse of something. Because Raz's last name is Aquato.
Oh boy.
Alright, now here we go. Second part of the fight.
Teriyaki salmon jerky over there in that clam. Why don't you go eat that instead? Hey, that helmet got spit at me in the brain tumbler vision.
Two. Whoa.
Hey, I see a piece of teriyaki salmon jerky over there in that clam. Why don't you go eat that? Poor gross little sucker fish. Can't breathe. I should kill him.
Box of nails. And honestly, he throws like a box of nails down in the river. I think just one or two more things, and then the fight will be over. And by that I mean like one or two more of these things where like he chases me. Because there's one part where like he starts to come into the bubble, I think, and we actually have to use the clams around here to fight him. Oh shit. At least I haven't been pulled out into the water yet. Alright, come on, come on. This is definitely one of the slower paced boss fights. But again, I like the way that it's done, that like, you know, it switches from like you fighting the boss to you running from the boss, but the boss is like, but it's like from the boss's perspective, chasing you. No, not many games do that nowadays. All right, Where are you? Yep, see, there we go. Come on, right here. 1, 2, 3. But yeah, I've seen pictures of lungfish and they're ugly in real life. 1, 2, 3.
Poor little thing.
That poor little thing just tried to kill me about 8 different ways.
Well, that's not its fault. This was once just a normal-sized lungfish, minding its own business in a mucus-lined air bubble beneath a semi-dry lake bed. But judging by the work done on it, I suspect Maury has mutated it, accelerated its growth, and has placed an implant in its brain to make it do his evil bidding.
Whoa. Poor little thing.
Yeah, go inside there and try to smash the implant. Use the psycho portal I saw you steal from Sasha's lab.
Oh, yeah. That works on big scary monsters?
Oh, monster schmonster. That thing's more afraid of you than you are of it. Now get in there!
Whoa. Poor little thing.
Alright, here we go.
Top of the morning to you, ma'am.
And good day to you, Officer of Lungfish. How are you today?
Oh, damp and happy, can't complain. And what are you and the wee one up to on this lovely day?
Oh, just obeying the law as always. All posted directives followed to the letter.
Ah, good to hear. Not a one of us want any trouble, that's for sure. Ah! Oh, Gagalo!
See what I mean why I love this, the lungfish's head, so much? And even then, Raz, like, look at the way he walks. He walks like an old school, like, 60s kaiju. And then you can also climb up on buildings. I just love this so much. All right, let's see. And now Raz, he doesn't do his, like, hand thing anymore. He does, like, an actual monster stomp. Water doesn't really bother him. Because it's all relative to your size, I guess.
Hey, Gagalore! Down here!
Excuse me. Were you talking to me?
Ow! My ears!
I'm sorry.
Oh, my God!
Are you okay?
He's dead.
Oh, geez, I'm sorry.
Don't worry. Every member of the Resistance is prepared to die fighting the tyranny of Kochamara.
What's Kochamara?
He's a giant monster like you, Gagalore. He brainwashed and enslaved almost everyone in Lungfishopolis.
That stinks. So, hey, have you seen any other humans around here? I'm looking for a girl called Lily.
The government archives might have some information about your young girlfriend, Gagalore.
Well, I don't know if she's really my girlfriend. I mean, I think she...
I only meant that she is your friend who was a girl, Gagalore. To access the archives, we must first destroy the broadcast tower Kochamara uses to control the populace.
Check. I'll go smash that then.
Wait, Gagalore! In order to reach the tower, you'll need to pass through that wall of lasers. But you'll never make it through the lasers without our help.
So are you gonna start helping soon?
First, I need you to do something for the Resistance. Punch a hole in that prison and free my comrades!
Oh man, just that whole thing of like, ah, my ears! Then all of a sudden he's dead.
Freedom!
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 Hoo-yah! Now, how about getting me past those gates?
Right. We stole the shield power module from Coach Amara. It's too big for any of us to operate, but it should work for you.
Is this gonna upset Kochamra and all your little brainwashed neighbors?
No!
I doubt it.
No.
So, knocking down the prison and then breaking this laser shield thing? Nobody's gonna get mad about that and start shooting at me.
No!
Maybe one guy would.
But what is even an entire navy of lungfish against the might and revolutionary zeal of Gogolor?
Wait, what navy?
Meet us at the dam, Gogolor. For freedom!
This is awesome.
The peaceful city of Lungfishopolis is under attack tonight by a hideous, gigantic monster the terrified citizens have named Gogolor. The Navy has responded quickly and decisively, dispatching its entire tank division to neutralize the creature. Soon, authorities say, everything will return to normal or better. Kidnapping human children is good.
Did you guys notice the voice actor for that one lungfish? That was actually, what's his name? Steve Bloom.
I'm Steve Bloom.
I can't do his voice, like, you know. He has such a distinct voice among voice actors. And right now I'm saving all of my psychic arrowheads and my regular arrowheads just because, like, it's gonna be a pain to find them all so I can get that cobweb duster, because I'm approaching like the later part of the game when you do need that to progress farther into the game. Oh shit, I barely saw it. I have enough for my to upgrade my thing.
Well, things have gotten a little embarrassing for Gogolor. Recently surfaced information has strongly linked the previously intimidating monster with common lowlife criminals. Earlier tonight, Gogolor broke some of his jailhouse cronies out of the slammer so they could enjoy a night on the town, popping pills and soliciting inexpensive cogger. Well, they're in for one nasty hangover. Our beloved Navy has come up with a high-tech new invention. Trucks armed with hyper-electricity. Kidnapping children do not harm the brains.
First tag. I feel like Godzilla in this. Ah, bitch.
Destruction and terror continue as the hulking, godless child beast carves a bloody swath through our helpless city. Our noble, all-volunteer Navy has been surprised only by the senseless lust for mayhem that seeps from the twisted black lump of a heart in this creature, still known only as Gogolor. Though it loathes violence in all its forms, the Navy has no choice but to activate its anti-monster turrets, which it guarantees are 100% monster-proof. Not get caught stealing children.
Alright. Well, time to go and, okay, let's see. Da-da-da. There we go. Come on. All right, there's the purse. Found your tag.
Freedom!
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 Freedom! So, this big monster, is that the best you could do?
We were short on time, and he is good at smashing things.
Doesn't look like much to me. Come on, let's blow this joint.
Hey, you're welcome.
Sorry about him, Gargalor. He's been in prison a long time. He's the only pilot the Resistance has, and he has an excellent plan. Meet us at the dam so we can put it into action.
I don't know if you guys can hear it, but can you hear like the similarity to like the original 1950 Godzilla's theme and this? See, this is why I love this game, you know. It has fun with itself. All the Double Fine's games have fun with themselves. You know, you have something like Psychonauts, but then you also have something like Brutal Legend along with it. Which, by the way, they need to do a sequel to Brutal Legend. And if you don't know, Brutal Legend's the game where you basically play as Jack Black if he was a roadie. Which is really, really funny and awesome. And it's M-rated. Oh, come on, come on. Damn it.
Hey, you prick.
Sort of hate how these guys have like the homing missiles. Speaking of which, I need to go back and watch like the 1950s Godzilla. I have it. At least I got it before it got me.
My tank!
And I love how like you just hear like you accidentally squish some of them.
Now you see the genius of our plan, Gargalor.
First we print flyers. Then we spread them all over town with my blimp.
Winning over the hearts and minds of Lungfishopolis in as soon as 6 months.
6 months?
you don't like our plan, you can come up with another one.
Yes, we are busy. We have to select card stock and then find a decent but inexpensive printer within the week.
Yep, that was their whole thing.
Have you come up with a better plan than the pamphlets yet?
Yeah, print it!
Careful, hey, my chai
what
tea!
What are you doing up there? Knock it off!
Year one. I forget which one, but he just goes, careful, my chai tea!
Careful, my chai tea!
See? Nailed it. Alright. Now that I have some free time, I'm gonna go talk to Ford.
Mmm, bacon. Hey, looks ready.
Yes.
Alrighty then.
And what's cool is that, like, every time you go to Ford, whenever you get a new power.
In recognition of your hard work, dedication, and mental agility, I'm proud to bestow upon you the official merit badge for invisibility. Okay, let's play a game. Look out, another sensor. Oh no, you're out of ammo.
No, I'm not.
You are now. Here are the rules. Take this guy out. But if he sees you at all, you lose. Go get him. Hey, where'd he go? Oh, well done. That's the power of invisibility. I think I've heard the kids around camp refer to this technique as silent but deadly. Rasputin, come up here. There's something you should see.
And this is basically explaining what we already know about the game.
You're the only one left, son. Can't even make a connection with Sasha or Mia right now for some reason.
Sasha said he had some official Psychonauts business.
Impossible. I would know it if they did. No, something's happened to them. Rasputin, listen. You're the only one who can stop Oleander now.
What about you?
I can't leave this cave, Rasputin. Not as the Ford Crawler you know.
What? Why?
Years ago, I was in a terrible psychic duel that left me barely alive.
Yeah, I read about that. They said your psyche was shattered, that you lost your mind. But you seem fine to me.
Yes, when I'm down here near the Sartanium Motherlode. The concentrated power of the Sartanium pulls my thoughts together, keeps me like my old self. But if I leave this sanctuary, my psyche becomes disjointed, and I fall into one of my other personalities, with no memory of who I really am. I'd be no use to you unless you needed something raked or mopped.
Well, you can call headquarters and get help.
The Psychonauts won't listen to me. They wrote me off as a loon years ago. That's why Sasha and Mia have to take on all my missions. Headquarters doesn't know I'm the one behind the assignment, so they'd never get approved. But Sasha and Mia seem to be out of commission now. You have to be my field agent, Rasputin. Are you ready?
Yes.
Good. You have to find where that monster took the girl. And if you locate any of the other children's brains along the way, bring them back to me for recranialization. Understand?
Ew. I mean, yes, sir.
Now, since I already found Dogen's brain, he should be all right.
What is the I'm ready to go back into the field. Okay.
But that's a cool thing that, like, he can pull you, like, you know, out of where you were and put you back. Instead of you having to go in throughout the entire level. See, now I'm back at the top of the dam.
Yep.
Now here is where the water is going to be a problem. So Raz can, like, go into water if it's, like, sort of, like, ankle deep, if I remember right. But if he goes down to his legs, then, you know, you get the whole thing where, like, that, and he jumps out of the water. It still makes me laugh that, like, he like, walks and moves like a, like Godzilla or any of the other kaiju monsters, you know, with his top half moving very back and forth, and his legs, like, swaying side to side, see? But this is a good place as any to get, like, psychic arrowheads, and health.
Yep.
Now, after this, I think I have just a few more Psi powers to collect. Because I think at rank 100 is when you actually get, like, everything. Up we go. No more citizens for me to accidentally squash. Now that ways to the tower that I gotta destroy. Alright, so up we go. Now, if only they went with, like, the whole thing where, like, you could carry one of the citizens up the towers. Make it like King Kong or something. There we go. I think I'm almost through with all the figments in this area. You just smack the shit out of the trains. Can you imagine if Godzilla did something like this? Well, I guess he sort of did, like when he started fly or did his dropkick.
We're here with the star of the popular sitcom Trouble in the Bubble, Buddy Finn. Buddy, what's your take on the Goggalore situation? Is he just misunderstood? No way! I hate Goggalore! I can't imagine anyone of my fans siding with the monster! He hates everything Lungfish care about! Air, water, family, the economy! Buddy, you'll be happy to know that the Navy has decided to pull out what they're most famous for! Airplanes! So rest assured, we can all look forward to Goggalore's imminent death. And to seeing you, buddy, every Thursday night at 8, right here on LBC. Thanks, and I'd just like to add that if anyone kidnaps a human child, they should take them quickly under the lake to the abandoned insane asylum.
Goggalore, come in. We have commandeered these vessels in your name.
We can put them in position to help you cross Cochamara Channel to get to Cochamara Island and destroy Cochamara Tower.
The thing is that, although we have the utmost faith that you will soon contain the area, Goggleore, we,
okay,
audio. We decided to maintain our position out here.
Just until you clear the area of all hostiles.
Yes.
For insurance reasons, Goggleore.
Yes, that, and for freedom.
Damn insurance premiums. Let me get off. Looks like I gotta go this way. See, now it's starting to feel like King Kong. Climb the skyscrapers and then take out the biplanes. Oh, shit. Did one of those guys just kamikaze me? And if so, how fast was he going to knock me off? Alright, there's the red bag. Ah, you fucking assholes. Go. That's
freedom!
All of them. Freedom! Yep. Come here, you. Oh yeah, and now I have upgraded my slam. So now, from higher up, if I mash the square button, I do a hell of a lot more damage. And it creates a new effect. See? Since I'm Goggleore right now and a giant kaiju, I don't use my hands, I just use my feet. But when you're regular sized Raz, it actually turns like, you know, that you're actually able to do stuff with like instead of it being feet, it's the hands, I meant to say. Alright, got that one. Just a few more. Alright, that's good for now. There's this one on this boat right here. There's a bag up there that I need to get.
Why doesn't that baby electric?
Shit. Ah, damn it.
We've faced monsters like you before, Goggleore.
Lungfish and Lobato.
My car!
kind of weird to see the lungfish watching TV, isn't it? Alright. I'm close to getting all the figments in this memory. And did you hear like some of the dialogue, like some of the lungfish are saying? Oh, it's like, my tank, or you're lucky we can't own guns. If only one of them yelled out, my cabbages, my life would be complete. And if you guys don't get that reference, then you're missing out on one of the best animated shows of all time.
Well, we're sorry to report that the miserable and incompetent Lungfish Navy is all but sunk. Great work, losers. Now, Kochamara himself will have to come all the way down here just to save our worthless hides. Authorities are calling for a big parade in Kochamara's honor after he clobbers the annoying giant Gogalore. And if the parade is big enough, Kochamara promises not to destroy the city. Brush teeth more often, don't drool so much.
And here we go, the boss battle.
Hey everyone, here comes Kochamara!
Yep.
Give up while you can, Gogalore.
I know it's you in there, Coach. I don't know where you're broadcasting from, but I'm gonna find out and make you show me what happened to Lily.
Kochamara does not speak giant monster boy language.
The only word you're gonna need is ouch.
Mighty... Ram! Deadly Triangle Beam!
That's...
Mighty Ram!
What's crazy is that, like, you have to fight...
Deadly Triangle Beam! Mighty Ram!
You have to fight, Kochamara.
Deadly Triangle Beam!
You have to fight him a specific way.
Triangle Beam! Some sashes showed you how to save up your aggressive energy, huh? Well, why don't I help you? Let it all out! Mighty Ram! Ground Vision! Overly intricate combination! Overly intricate combination! Hard to avoid! Area attack! Overly intricate combination! Hard to avoid! Area attack! Overly intricate combination!
Watch it!
Hard to avoid! Area attack! Oh! Overly intricate combination! Hard to avoid! Area attack! Oh! Oh!
Now he starts flying around again for...
Ram! Deadly Triangle the beam!
All right, come on, coach.
Triangle beam! Deadly triangle beam! Mighty ramp! Ground vision! Overly intricate combination!
Watch it!
Overly intricate combination! Hard to avoid area attack!
One, two.
Overly intricate combination! Yep. Hard to avoid area attack! People of Lungfishopolis, I'm sorry I let you down.
Finally! Okay, Tower, get ready for Gogolore. Well, he was evil, but he did build a lot of roads.
All right, up we go.
Control of this freaky toad. I don't need him to nab children for me anymore. I've got the brain of a little girl back in my lab that's strong enough to power a whole army of psychoblaster death tanks. Huh? What?
You've got the brain of a little girl?
I said, in my lab.
I think you've got the muscles of a little girl, too.
Good one.
It is I, the creature whose spirit was once, over here. Behind you? Yes.
Oh.
The creature whose spirit was once enslaved by the Evil One. You have unchained my soul, and now I shall repay you, powerful human child.
Oh, great. Well, okay, show me what you did to my friend Lily.
By the drowned spirit of Oblongata, it is done.
Oh boy, I love that level.
Lake. You may return to either shore and summon me with that.
Thanks, hulking lungfish. You know, you really aren't as hideous as people say.
You may call me now by my true name, Rasputin. The name given to me by my people.
And what name is that, noble lake creature?
Linda.
What a magical lady.
All right. Got Lily's bracelet.
Have you crows seen a... Hey, I was talking to you, jerks.
Can't see it.
Lloyd.
Who are you working for?
What? I'm with the Psychonauts.
The who? Oh, that doesn't fit in. That doesn't fit in at all. Maybe I've got this all wrong. Oh, okay, okay, but... No, no, wait, I mean... This sucks. Sparring with...
Who do you work for?
I'm the guard. I've been fully trained. Who are the puppet masks?
You gotta let me in. My friend's in there.
Sorry, the milkman has the key. I am not the milkman. I'm the guard.
Let's see, how long have I been recording for?
Olives with the fluorite producers.
All right, that's enough time for me to be recording. I'm going to end that episode here. Now we're going to start getting into the really fun levels of the mines, because now we're in an insane asylum. Anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. And if you guys are liking this, be sure to hit that little bell. It really helps out, you know, whenever I do my videos and everything.
Because they want.
Anyway, I'll see you all later in the next episode of Psychonauts.
But they can't hide that they...